They were raised on the Disney Channel, they listened to Taylor Swift and had iPhones as their first phones. But enough about Maddie McLean.
I was thinking, is this about me?
They are the 2000s babies and they are now technically adults.
A new television series will air next week following 5 2000s babies as they prepare for their 21st birthdays. Growing up in a digital age, jobs called social media influencer and TikTok famous are what many of them dream of. Let's take a look.
Bro, what is our life? I'm on my way to pick up my dream chihuahua, bro. Yay. Been waiting for this moment. I feel like everybody needs to have a chihuahua. It's just an accessory, you know? I can't see them.
Oh, stop, over there.
Oh, my God.
And we're joined now by Misha and that chihuahua.
Hello.
alongside Rafferty, who was featured in another episode of 2000s Babies. The second episode, right, Rafferty?
To my knowledge.
Yeah.
I think so.
Well, welcome. Yeah. Welcome into the studio.
I didn't even notice there was a dog. So quiet and so well behaved.
Very well behaved. I train him well.
welcome in. I said to you two as I sat down, I said, this is iconic behaviour. Look at the two of you.
Always. This is just on top.
Everyday sort of.
Yeah, this is the casual. Yeah. I was going to wear a bikini.
Is this genuinely what you would wear every day?
Yeah, of course.
We like to switch it up, you know.
Yeah, if I'm not wearing a bikini, I'm wearing my pyjamas, so.
Well, you're making Kamal and I feel very old right now.
I feel so old.
You were born in the year 2000 and you're now both 21.
Yes, sir.
Isn't that crazy? I mean, does it feel crazy, first of all, for you two to be 21?
Yes, it's the prime age, my favourite age, so yeah.
Yeah, I feel like everyone hypes it up as you get older. Like when you're a kid, you think, yeah, when I turn 21, it's going to be the thing. I'm going to be an adult. I have my stuff together. But okay, you never really do.
You said the word, adult, and we said it in our intro. You're technically an adult. I think that's a movable feast these days, right? I mean, what is an adult? I'm 40 and I'm definitely not an adult.
Me?
I don't know. I think like as we grow older, we just reinvent what that means for ourselves and we find what that means every so often, you know?
We obviously live in a world now where we're all used to having cell phones and social media and all the rest of it. But for many of us, Kamal and I included, and most of our audience, that's not the way they grew up. They didn't grow up with those things. Do you think it makes a difference for you two to have kind of grown up in a world where you have a cell phone from all a very early age?
Yeah, for sure. There's like negatives to that too, because now I'm blind. Like I need like glasses. I'm wearing contacts right now. So if I didn't have my phone, I would literally have 20/20 vision. So
just from staring at your phone too much.
Yeah, literally, it's because that damn phone, as my mum said.
Do you feel like it has made a difference to your life?
I don't know. When I think about my childhood, I think it came kind of on the cusp of, you know, you had Video Easy, you used to be able to go to the video store, get out the video, and you have to take it back the next day. And now everything's so accessible. And I look at people that are even younger than us, like 10-year-olds now, and they live on their iPads, and it's not the sort of childhood that I quite remember. True, I feel like I just got to see everything really coming out and we got to embrace both sides of that. And
I think I feel like we're the last generation to like have both, like
a little bit of innocence.
Yeah, a little bit.
Do you have any concerns about the fact that your entire lives are out there on social media forever? You know, the idea that once you post anything on Instagram or TikTok, it is there. Even if you deleted it, you know, there's an imprint. Yeah. Do you have any concerns about just having your whole life out there?
Not at all.
No. I like that. I want to remember it. You know?
I think you have to be really conscientious of, like, the things that you post. I mean, like, people's workplaces now, they look up your social media before they even want to hire you these days. True. And that's something we all have to be conscious of. And I think that's what a lot of young people now are starting to become more conscious of.
All right, Misha, tell us about the show, 2000s Babies. It's really exciting, right?
Yeah, so exciting. Yeah, I'm super excited. So basically, it's just like a show, documentary/reality show about five different New Zealanders born in the 2000s that, yeah, and it's like we're all from different walks of life and what our life is like to be as a 21-year-old in this generation. So, yeah, it's pretty exciting.
Amazing. You got to see it last night.
Yeah,
right?
The premiere.
How was it?
Yeah, it was really surreal. Like, we're really on TV or whatever.
Well, TV, I mean. You know, that's surreal in the first place.
I wanted to know from the two of you before we go. You know, you are you're adults now. You're 21. What do you want to do with your life, Misha?
I just want to have fun. City girls just want to have fun in the city.
I don't know yet, and I don't think many people know what they're going to do with themselves. Right now, I study law and sociology, and I'm in my fourth year currently. And I don't know what that's going to mean for me in the future, but I'm hoping it's something good.
Yeah. True. Good luck. Yeah. Good luck with it.
Yeah, good luck to the both of you. Thank you for joining us. And congratulations
thank you for having us.
Thank you for coming in, and congratulations on the series as well. It is on TVNZ On Demand as well as across our channels as well, starting on Monday.
Monday, period.
Misha and Rafferty and Bimbo. Thank you so much for coming. Really appreciate it.
I think I just aged a little bit more.